childhood lead poisoning levels and the connection to poverty rates and the age of housing.
Presented by Azalea Bailey and Ben Solliday.
Childhood lead poisoning is a serious public health concern. According to the CDC, there are at least 4 million households where there is a risk for lead exposure. Any blood level above 5 micrograms per deciliter has been reported as an elevated level.
The main source of lead exposure for young children is from lead paint in their homes. In addition, older homes are more likely to use lead parts for plumbing either as solder or lead pipes.
Lead seepage into the drinking water in Flint, Michigan has caused a massive public health crisis. The problem began when the city switched its water supply in 2014 to a cheaper alternative. The supply pipes had sustained major corrosion and lead was leaching into the water.
In New York City's public housing complexes, 820 children younger than 6 were found to have elevated blood lead levels. The apartments were not inspected due to loopholes in city policy.
In the Hudson Valley, when there is a greater percentage of older homes in poverty, the percentage of children with elevated blood lead levels increases as well. On average, the graphs reveal how poverty and blood lead levels correlate to each other in different counties in the Hudson Valley. For instance, in the county of Erie, as the pink line increases, which represents the percentage of children in poverty, the percent of elevated blood lead levels in children, or the purple line, increases as well.
If a child has a blood lead level below 5 micrograms per deciliter, they experience a decrease in cognitive function.
10 micrograms per deciliter results in the previous symptoms and decreased hearing.
10 to 40 micrograms per deciliter results in the previous symptoms, decreased nerve function, and decreased hemoglobin.
40 to 80 micrograms per deciliter results in the previous symptoms as well as abdominal pain, colic, vomiting, constipation, and anorexia.
Above 80 micrograms per deciliter results in the previous symptoms as well as convulsions, coma, and death.
To counteract lead poisoning, it's important that the government continues to pass laws concerning home inspection and renovation. This graph shows how lead poisoning prevention policies have reduced blood lead levels over time.
Parents and caregivers can prevent children from lead poisoning by keeping them away from peeling paint, washing toys often, especially teething toys, washing hands after play, before meals, and before bed, using uncracked and lead-free dishes, staying away from remodeling and renovation sites, cleaning the dust from sills and window wells at least once a month, and feeding children food with iron, calcium, and vitamin C.
Thank you so much for watching and stay safe.